What's going on YouTube? This is Wayne with Wayne's Fish World, and this week I'm coming at you guys with another species video. And this week we're going to be doing on the one and only, my favorite Tetra, the fish that got me started on all other schooling fish, the Neon Tetra. The Neon Tetra is a beautiful little fish that resides in the Amazon basin. It comes from clear and black water streams and rivers. This fish is absolutely stunning. It's a little tiny gem, and it's just about as colorful as freshwater ever get. This fish highly resembles its cousin, the cardinal tetra. The two difference between those fish is one, that the cardinal tetra has a red and blue solid line from the head to the tail, while the neon tetra's colors are kind of broken up. Another big difference is cost. The cardinal tetras are going to cost more than the neon tetras. Personally, I believe that neon tetras are a little more finicky than the cardinal tetras, even though we are told and recommended that the cardinal tetras are more difficult to care for. If you have experience in both the fish, you know what I mean. These little fish, I wouldn't want to see them going in anything less than a 10-gallon aquarium. Now, the reason I'm saying that is because, yes, they could fit and live happily in a school of 6 or maybe 12 in a 5-gallon aquarium, but these fish love dense vegetation. They need hiding spots. They love driftwood. They love rock work. These fish need to be in a tank that adequately provides for the fish. When you set up an aquarium, you want to base that aquarium around the fish that you are keeping, not the other way around. You don't want to set up an aquarium and then say, hey, I want to get this fish. You need to set up a habitat for the species that you want to keep. These fish do not want to be blasted by halides or high output T5s or LEDs. These fish need shady spots. They love to hide. When you see these fish constantly schooling, that's actually a bad thing. That means they don't feel safe, they're insecure, and they're tense. When you see the fish that are in loose groups singled out, that means your fish feels safe. If you want your fish to stay in a tight group, then introduce bigger fish like Bolivian rams or electric blue rams or cockatoos. These fish are not too big, they're not going to bother the neon tetras, and it's still going to force the neon tetras to stay a little closer. My number one question I get on my channel is, Wayne, how do you keep your angelfish with your neons? Well, it's two basic things. Raise your angelfish with neons when they're babies. And second of all, hope they don't eat the neons when they get bigger. But most of the time, not promising you, but most of the time, when you raise baby angelfish with neons, they see them as friends and not food. But there is that case when that angelfish grows up and it fits in its mouth. Well, guess what? It's going to eat it. Neon tetras are peaceful little fish. They're not going to hurt anybody. These are just a peaceful, rewarding little fish. Keep acidic water parameters. They do come from the Amazon River. So pH around 6.5, keep your temperature around 72, 75, 76. That's going to be just fine for them. If you want to breed these fish, turn off all the lights and get a pair. Constantly raise the light levels and eventually the fish will breed. You can also introduce more meaty foods like mosquito larvae and frozen meat food. That'll kind of boost the chances of breeding possibilities. This is a rewarding fish, guys. What's your favorite tetra? What's your favorite schooling fish? Tell me the results and your experiences of your tetras, guys. Leave your thoughts and comments in the section below. Make a recommendation for next week's species video. Comment, rate, and subscribe. This is Wayne with Wayne's Fish World. I'll see you all next week. Later.